This is Vader Reviews. We are honored that you would join us for my reaction to the new trailer for The Book of Boba Fett, coming to Disney Plus December 29th. It's been a while since I've had any good Star Wars to discuss, so needless to say, I was pretty excited when I saw this new trailer had been released. It was certainly a rare pleasure to see Temuera Morrison once again as a manly Mandalorian bounty hunter. His sheer ferocity in Season 2 of The Mandalorian makes me very excited to see what this series has to offer, since according to Robert Rodriguez, this series will be all killer, no filler. But before we begin, it has come to my attention that last weekend, while I was gone and we only had a skeleton crew, some numbskull thought it would be humorous to pirate my airwaves. The bony little creep even stole my pun gimmick. Well, listen here, Bonaparte, and get this through your thick skull. Puns are my thing, and I have a bone to pick with anyone who tries to steal my thunder. My men are working the graveyard shift to dig up any information on your whereabouts, and when we find you, we'll see who the pun master really is. Get ready, Bonehead, because I'm gonna bury you. But now, is the Force with this trailer, or will it choke on its aspirations? Only one way to find out. Let's start this bad boy in 3, 2, 1. Spider droid. Do you think it has Wi-Fi so it can surf the web? Is that a pit droid handing him his helmet? He's got eyebrows again. I like that they actually weathered his helmet this time. I didn't like that fresh coat of paint they gave him in Season 2 of The Mandalorian. It made it look like plastic. I agree with Anthony Ferraro from Create Sci-Fi. Dings and scratches always tell a story and make a prop look more real.
Jabba ruled with fear.
Kind of essential for a crime lord.
I intend to rule with respect.
Respect is nice, but fear is a powerful ally.
You are once captains under Jabba the Hutt.
I'm here to make a proposal that's mutually beneficial.
Show him a magic trick with a pencil that worked for Joker in The Dark Knight.
Why speak of conflict when cooperation can make us all rich?
Couple of Twi'leks. Always great to see the Slave One.
What prevents us all from killing you and taking what we want?
Should've gone with the weak way, gee whiz. Those look wizard, those ray shields remind me of Episode 1.
If he had spoken such insolence to Jabba, he'd have fed you to his menagerie.
Please, speak freely.
I know you've been in a Sarlacc pit for a while there, Boba, but that's not how things work anymore. Speaking freely will get you put in Twitter jail real fast. But since you said to speak freely, let's discuss this trailer. There are pros and cons, so let's get the dark side out of the way first. For one thing, there was a sad lack of any wow moments in this trailer. I kept waiting for a real show of strength from Boba Fett. Perhaps a disintegration, or the use of his flamethrower. But that moment never arrived. And worse still, there were times when they unintentionally made him appear weak as a ruler. Allow me to explain. When the Grinch here threatens to kill Boba Fett and take everything he has, Fennec Shand says if they had ever spoken to Jabba the Hutt in this manner, they would already be dead. This makes Fett appear weak in two ways. First, by taking a level of disrespect Jabba would have never allowed, this makes Fett a weaker leader than Jabba in the eyes of his old lieutenants. Secondly, Boba Fett allows Fennec Shand to speak for him rather than dealing with the issue himself. In a crime syndicate, showing weakness of any kind is a death sentence. And when your authority is challenged, a true leader would have put his lieutenant in his place. And after threatening Fett's life, that place would have been in the ground as a warning to everyone in attendance that he is in command here. You also have to remember, Boba Fett is a Mandalorian. A harsh and brutal warrior culture. Moreover, he was the one bounty hunter I singled out of the crowd to make sure he wouldn't disintegrate Captain Solo in Episode 5. So to me, it feels very out of character for him to allow this scum to threaten his life in such a blatant challenge to his leadership. To put it simply, this is not the way. And while it may seem like I'm being very hard on this teaser, I did enjoy parts of it. Everyone seems to be discussing how his scars have diminished. And if you'll notice, when Boba is putting on his helmet at the beginning of the teaser, there's a piece of equipment in the background. And while it may be an intergalactic tanning bed, my money is on a Bacta unit, which would explain his healed appearance and why he's also suiting back up. I enjoyed the use of all the classic Star Wars aliens throughout the trailer. The Athorians, the Twi'lek, Trandoshans, and the fact that we finally got some fat Gamorrean guards once again. The ray shields remind me of Episode 1, when the shield separated Obi-Wan from Qui-Gon and Darth Maul during their climactic duel on Naboo. And while this city here is most likely the capital of Tatooine, my old stomping ground, I couldn't help but think it might have been Wizard if this was a new city built in the crater of what used to be Jeddah. But those are my thoughts on the trailer. What'd you think of it? Before we go, this week's video was brought to you by the generosity of Snowtrooper Captain Noah Dingley and I'm just happy to be a Stormtrooper, Adam Jordan. The Empire thanks you for your service, my friends. This has been Vader Reviews. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that bell for notifications. And follow me on Twitter, at Vader Reviews. Join the Empire today. You do not yet realize your importance. Share these videos, and together, we will rule the internet. And always remember, you don't know the power of the dark side.